when cosmic rays propagate through space, they will sometimes undergo interactions and produce secondary particles. Some of them are unstable and they produce neutrinos. The cosmogenic neutrino flux is a more specific scenario that is directly associated with the highest energy cosmic rays interacting on the cosmic photon flux, the result of the Big Bang.
Asteroids' physical neutrinos are kind of so-called in situ neutrinos, which are produced at cosmic ray accelerators, like black holes or GRBs. But the cosmogenic neutrinos itself is kind of off situ, which means that the production is made during the propagation from the source to the Earth in our galaxy.
The cosmogenic neutrino is the highest energy neutrino in the universe, and the astrophysical neutrino has wide energy range.
Begin the IceCube construction, we are trying to precisely calculate what would be an event rate with the IceCube, and it still says kind of optimistic numbers, like okay, even 1 to 2 or 3 events per year, which was kind of encouraging to us.
It is hard to assign a probability to assumptions that go into these predictions, but certainly many of us, including myself, think that IceCube should have a good shot of observing a cosmogenic neutrino flux in a number of several years.
Because we know there is an ultra-high energy cosmic rays with energies up to the 10 to 20th electron volt, which is 20 orders of magnitudes higher than a visible light. We believe that there are secondary produced neutrinos also with energies up to the similar energy range, like 10 to the 18th or 10 to the 19th electron volt. Interactions occurred relatively very close to the source region, so their direction still points back to where they originally comes from, which means that detection of cosmogenic neutrinos should tell us which direction we should look at to search for their origin.
Sources of astrophysical neutrinos are not necessarily also the sources of cosmogenic neutrinos. Cosmogenic neutrinos must come from an area where these highest energy cosmic rays exist, are accelerated. One possible scenario, for example, are the relativistic jets outflows from in the vicinity of supermassive black holes in active galaxies.
There are several experiments which searched cosmogenic neutrinos. However, these experiments failed. We thought that IceCube is the first cosmogenic neutrino detector because of its size and also the capability of detecting 3 types of neutrinos. So if we could measure 3 types, that means 3 times more chances.
The way it works is neutrinos that interact with matter inside IceCube or nearby IceCube produce secondary particles. And these charged particles travel with this almost with the speed, vacuum speed of light through the medium and produce light. Normal visible light, Cherenkov photons there, we call them. And IceCube catches a small fraction of that light, but that is sufficient to determine the energy and the direction of these particles.
What you're going to do is, in principle, look for very bright events you've never seen before.
Our search started right after the IceCube started to take data with few strings. But at that time, the IceCube is still small. The most recent result uses 7 years of the data.
We saw 2 events, but those energies are not high enough to be claimed as an cosmogenic neutrinos.
The highest energy neutrinos that were seen by IceCube are the energy range of about 10 PeV. The typical energy for cosmogenic neutrinos are above 100 PeV and more typical even 1000 PeV. To date, we have not seen cosmogenic neutrinos yet, simply because the flux is too low, obviously. That is the most obvious result of the non-observation of cosmogenic neutrinos to date. So that means that some models are already ruled out and we will have to build a bigger detector, or we'll perhaps in the next few years we'll see finally some events.
If we don't see anything, this puts us kind of mysterious situation again, because we've been talking about huge black holes or gamma ray bursts or radio loud jets as a kind of champion of the candidate of ultra-high energy cosmic ray source origins.
So we can exclude a model where highest energy cosmic rays consist largely of protons. Neutrino astronomy at highest energies allows us to explore the ultra-high energy universe in a unique way.
Every year we look at the data and we check data, and every year we are so excited because there could be a huge cosmogenic neutrino.
Because only one or two events are good enough to understand and finally identify cosmic ray source origins.